Holy shit.
So do you remember when you could one-shot kill a bulldozer on the highest difficulty? You don't? Let me remind you, back in 2017 I made this build video that showed how easy it was to do. Back then, with the dozers having less health than they currently do, and some of the skills being broken, it allowed the heavy crossbow to easily take down our friendly foes in one swift shot. This was subsequently changed, and this way of taking down dozers was removed. So recently I started to wonder, after many updates to the game and health changes to the dozers, is it actually possible to do this now? If you discount the rocket launchers and try to achieve this with a regular weapon, there's a bunch of things we can attempt to do. So let's see if we can make this work. First things first, we need to know what kind of damage we are needing to inflict here. All bulldozers, except for two in this game, have a health of 24,000 on the highest difficulty, the headless dozer having half that at 12,000, and the minigun dozer doubling that at 48,000. Another important thing to note about bulldozers is their faceplates, which means that we'll also need some armor piercing too. So knowing these numbers, can we create a viable weapon that can give us 24,000 damage or even 48,000 damage and take out the real big lads? What we need to do is reverse engineer these numbers to find out if it's achievable in one shot. Alright, let's get to it. First off, we need a high damage weapon. Let's take a look around and see what we can find.
Trash.
The Thanatos sniper, 3,500 damage with armor piercing because it's a sniper rifle. This should work great as a base. Now we want to bolt on some skills and boost this puppy up a little. There are five main skills we can use for this, but one of them is kind of cancelled out by the other, so we'll take the better of the two and also the safest. Let's talk about those two first. They are Underdog Basic and High Value Target Aced. Underdog Basic can give us a small damage increase of 15%, but only when we are within 18 meters of the enemy, a little too close for comfort when we're trying to deal with bulldozers. High Value Target Aced, however, creates a nice little distance between us and our heavy armored friends, and gives us a whopping 50% damage boost. All we have to do is wave our crosshair over the enemy or manually call them out. Stay 10 meters back and we're good to go. Okay, great, first boost acquired. Now we want to stick with another solid damage booster, and that would be Berserker Aced. If you don't know what that is, it's a skill that boosts your damage relative to your lowered health. To get anything from this skill at all, you need to have your health below 50%, and then it's incrementally increased the lower your health goes, up to a maximum of 100% if you have zero health, so literally barely alive. A good combo for this skill is sometimes to utilize the Frenzy skill, which automatically caps your health at 30%, which in Berserker terms means we would get a 40% damage boost at the very least. Again, if we go lower, that number will increase. The final two are more situational and timed, starting with the Overkill Aced skill. Here we ace this to allow the boost on all weapons except launchers and melee, and grants us a further 75% damage boost for 20 seconds. But we do have to initiate this with a shotgun kill first. So, kill with a shotgun, get 75% damage boost, switch to the Thanatos, get a kill, got it. The last one here is a dice roll, and it's the critical hit chance with the Unseen Strike skill. The brief description of critical hits refers to what is known as headshot multipliers. We all know that if you hit enemies in the head, you do more damage than body shots. The amount of damage the headshot does is calculated as a percentage of a regular shot. For example, if a regular body shot did 100 damage, and when you hit a headshot it did 500 damage, then the headshot multiplier would have been 5. What is calculated for bulldozers for Payday 2 on the death sentence difficulty is a headshot multiplier of 7.5. So by granting a critical hit, we can multiplicatively boost our damage by 7.5 times yet again. So with many factors here, it's important to know what kind of numbers we're dealing with as we add these in. Here you can see the variety of tests and how they all add together. First off, taking a body shot with high value target activated, landing a nice 6,375 damage. Then I'll activate Berserker as best I can here using grenades. I tried Molotovs but couldn't get as low as I wanted, so trying grenades. I'm not sure what my health is here, but I dare say I couldn't get it much lower, so I'm getting an extreme boost from Berserker Aced here. With Berserker alone activated, I now get 8,203 damage. We're certainly getting somewhere now, a third of the way to our 24,000, but still pretty far away from our 48,000. Then I put together Berserker and High Value Target, boosting up now to a little over 12,000 damage. Halfway there at this point, or 25% to our Minigun Dozer total. The next one I added in was Overkill. Seeing as I need to get a shotgun kill to start this skill off, I have my Judge Shotgun with Dragon's Breath rounds. Once I get this kill, I have 20 seconds of a 75% damage boost on my sniper rifle. Here you can see we now hit for 21,421 damage, just shy of the 24,000 needed. This is where we will need to introduce Mr. Critical Hits into the equation. This will easily push us over this, as even a 2x damage would take down a Dozer at this point, never mind the 7.5x that a Dozer headshot multiplier sits at.
Fuck off, Dozer!
Here you can see that when a critical hit lands, denoted by the colour of the pop-up on my Wolfwood settings, we kill with a 24,000 damage shot. Now with that information, let's see if we can take down the big fella himself.
How do you like that? Sleep tight, Dozer.
Well, yes, pretty easily when you do the maths, because if we do 21,000 damage without critical hits, multiplying via critical hits, we go way over the 48,000 needed to take the big guys down. With that being said, there's a possibility to remove some of these skills from the list in order to make this happen, as we're way above where we need to be. I just wanted to demonstrate a maximum damage output to see what was possible. I will show this in effect in a game scenario now, using mutators to spawn only bulldozers, but what I had an issue in this instance was activating the overkill skill as the guards left pretty quickly, but you will see the results. I'll also zip through the skills really quick at the end if you wanted to implement this crazy power into a build of your own. It could fit within all your favourite perk decks, just grabbing the skills I mentioned to boost up the power. So for the skills on the skill trees themselves, I'm just going to show you the ones I listed and throw in some potentials, but it's really about fitting this into your builds if you wanted to try it. Let me first note that due to a recent stat reset and my 8th time grinding back to max Infamy, I'm currently sitting at Infamy 7, level 93, and I didn't take all skill tier Infamy reductions yet due to wanting to rank up faster, so I took the XP boost bonuses instead. So I'll point out the extras I had to pick up that you may not have to based on your Infamy. The bare bones, nothing in Mastermind yet, of course. Enforcer, the shotgun skills I mentioned earlier, all the way to Overkill Ace. I wouldn't be taking Shotgun Impact Basic here, but it's an Infamy reduction thing like I just mentioned. So an extra 2 points in your back pocket for removing this. Nothing in Technician yet either. Basic Mobility, Duck and Cover and Parkour Basic, always needed. Then it's Silent Killer skills to get to Unseen Strike for critical hits, grabbing the high value target skill Ace on the way. Whatever combo you desire here to get Unseen Strike, then it's also your call if you want to ace this skill too. Due to Infamy, you can also remove 2 points from this section to get Unseen Strike due to Milo Infamy. I didn't take Unseen Strike Ace purely because staying unscathed for 18 seconds on death sentence seems impossible for me. To prompt the crit chance for me on the spawner, I grenade myself to reset the skill, and then I had to wait 4 seconds of no damage in order to receive the 6 seconds of crit chance. In the gameplay, the bulldozer shot too fast, and I found it a little difficult to activate the skill within the 20 second timer of the overkill skill still ticking too. Finally, in Fugitive is 9 Lives Ace for playing with the 1 down modifier on, and then the Berserker Ace skill like I previously mentioned. Here you have the option to continue this skill to the Frenzy skill if you want that damage reduction in your build along with a constant Berserker state with reduced health. So with all that, it leaves 53 skill points remaining if you didn't take the non-infamy skills that I did. With that and the perk deck you choose, you can work around these skills pretty well, or even remove one or two and still be able to do some serious damage. For clarity, in the gameplay I show, I used Rogue as I needed to not get hit as I was trying to take my own shots. So the 50% dodge helped me a little with that, although when I did get tagged, it was pretty much game over. In the spawner gameplay, I used Anarchist. I used this in gameplay also but got wrecked too fast with 10 dozers shooting at me all at once. I did find it easy to lower my health to a really low amount using Anarchist by gauging the armor. Anyways, it was a fun little test to do and can be a neat trick if it's added into a solid Anarchist, Stoic or Kingpin build. Let me know in the comments what perk decks you'd run with this and what are the skills you take to make it more usable. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you next time.